गुड मॉर्निंग ग्रेड 7। इन सेट 13 वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड एलसीएम ऑफ गिवन नंबर्स। नाउ फर्स्ट लेट अस सी व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एलसीएम। सो एलसीएम इज नथिंग बट लीस्ट कॉमन मल्टीपल। नाउ फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इज 12 एंड 15 आर टू नंबर्स। आई विल टेल यू थ्री मेथड्स ए बी सी हाउ टू फाइंड एलसीएम, and then you can follow any method which is suitable for you or which you find easy. Now see, if I want to find least common multiple, multiple you know, least means the minimum and which is common to both the numbers. If I take 12 and 15, the very basic method, first you write 12's table, then you write 15's table. All right, now after this you find out which are multiples. These are all multiples of 12, no? And these are all our multiples of 15. So first let us see which are common multiples. Now I want to find common. Common is 60 over here. Here also it is 60. Again some common multiples over here. Yes, you have 120 over here. And you have 120 as here as well. Okay. So you go on writing the table till you get at least 2 common multiples. Now I got till 10 only. If I wrote the table till 10, I got 2 multiples. But I want what? Which are common. So which are common? 60 and 120 are common multiples. But what is least? Least means what? Minimum. So always minimum is 60. No, 120 is bigger than 60. So I don't want the greater one. I want the smaller one. Least common multiple. So these are all multiples and minimum or least is 60, and therefore my LCM is 60. It is as easy as this. But because these numbers are smaller, it is easy to write their tables. And if you don't get common multiple, even if you write few numbers, then you have to write the whole table, isn't it? And therefore it is better to go for the next method. This is very useful if the numbers are very small and you know the tables very well. Alright. Now look another method. 12 and 15 are numbers. What do? I break up 12. 12 is 2 into 6. This is as good as prime factorization. And 6 can be written as 2 into 3. So at the end, what is 12? 2 into 2 into 3. How can I write 15? 15 is 3 into 5. Now, how to find LCM? You write all the common factors into uncommon factors. Now 2, 2, 3 and 3, 5. Which are common in this? See, 3 is common to both. So which is common, I will write only once. Now 3, I have written once. Now remaining uncommon factors you have to write. Which are uncommon? 2, 2 and 5. So 2, 2 and 5. And then I carry out this multiplication. 3 over here, 2, 2's are 4, 5, 4, 5's are 20. And 3 into 20, again we get LCM as 60. This is second method. Now third method, which is little easier, you just see. We have done HCF in the similar way. Alright. Now, in case of LCM, what do we do? Write 12 and 15. Now you first start with a lowest prime number or lowest number, which is dividing both the numbers completely. So 3 is dividing 12, I get 4. 3 is dividing 15, I get 5. 3 4s are 12. 15 is divided by 3 and 12 is also divided by 3. I can't take 2 because 15 is not divisible by 2. So I have taken 3. Now once I get this, what I get over here? 4 and 5. Now I have to find one number which is dividing both. It is not possible. So I have to stop here. And what will be your LCM? Your LCM is these numbers into all these numbers. So I have to write 3 over here. And here remaining are 4 and 5. So I am writing it over here. I get 60. Alright, so these three methods I have shown for first problem. Henceforth, I am going to follow this method. Choice is yours, you find, but this is easier method. Now see, three numbers are there. I would like to tell you one thing over here. Three numbers given in the second problem are 6, 8 and 10. So just listen to the rules. First, you take smallest prime number, which is dividing all the three numbers at a time. Okay. Afterwards, you should consider another number which is dividing all the numbers. But if it is not possible, then you take at least two numbers. Okay, you choose a number which is dividing at least two numbers. If that is also not possible, then you stop. Now here first all three are divisible by 2. So I got here 3, 4 and 5. Now I have to choose a number which is dividing all three. Is it possible? No. okay, then not 3, at least 2. Any two numbers are divisible by any number? No. So I have to stop. Again my LCM will be this numbers multiplied by these numbers. So what I get? First is 2 and then 3, 4, 5. So 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. Again here 6, 3 2s are 6, 4 5s are 20. And together I get 120 over here. Got it? So that is the second problem. Third problem, see, 18 and 32 are two numbers. So ending itself tells you the numbers are divisible by 2. So I'm trying with 2 first. As I divide by 2, first I get 9 and 16. And now there is not a single number which is dividing both the numbers. This is divisible by 3 and this is not divisible by 3. So I have to stop because my condition is at least minimum 2 numbers should be divisible by one digit over or one number over here. Alright. If it is not possible, I have to stop. Then what am I writing? It is 2 over here and this. Again, this into this. So 9, 2 into 9 into 16. 2 into 9 into 16. This multiplication you carry out as per your convenience. I feel 16 2s are 32 is very easy and then I can multiply these by 9. You can do 2 9s are 18 and multiply 18 by 16. I find this as easy, choice is yours. So 32 into 9 becomes 288. Alright, I hope the method is clear. Okay, let's go for the another problems. Let's go for fourth problem. Numbers are 10, 15 and 20. Now, all these numbers are divisible by 5. We can start with 2 also because these 2 were divisible by 2. So we could have taken 2 also. Doesn't matter. Actually, first you have to take 2 and then 5. But if at glance, if you feel it is divisible by 5, you write by 5. All the 3 numbers are divisible by 5. So I have chosen 5. So here 2s are, here 3s are and 4s are. As per rules, choose those numbers which are dividing all 3 at a time. Okay, then you choose the number which are dividing at least 2 at a time. Here 15 is not divisible by 2. So I have chosen 5. Because 20, 15 and 10, all 3 are divisible by 5. I hope you have understood this. So 2, 3 and 4. Now 2, 3 and 4. Choose such a number which is dividing all the 3 numbers at a time. This is not possible, isn't it? 2 and 3, they are consecutive natural numbers. That means they are co-prime. They can't be divisible by any other number. Alright. So now forget about 3 columns, select 2 numbers which are divisible by single number. So 2 and 4 both are divisible by 2, so I have chosen 2 over here. So first I am repeating again, in case of 3 numbers, first you choose such a number which is dividing all 3 at a time. Okay, then again repeat the same action. Actually all 3 should be divided, but if it is not possible, then you choose such a number which is dividing at least 2 numbers at a time. So I have chosen 2 which is dividing 2 as well as 4. So we get here 1, 3 as it is and 2. Now what is LCM as we have seen? The numbers which are present in the first column multiply by numbers which are present in the last row. So in the last row we have 1 into 3 into 2 and column you have 5 and 2. So your LCM is 5 into 2 into 3 into 2. Into 1 doesn't matter. 1 is there, so I have not written. So your LCM becomes 10 into 6 which is 60. Now look at fifth problem, very interesting, 45 and 86. There is not a single number which is dividing both of these numbers. Then what to do? So LCM will be product of both the numbers. Mind well, in case of HCF, what we have seen? If there is not a single number which is dividing both the numbers, your HCF is 1. In case of LCM, if there is not a single number which is dividing both the numbers, your LCM is product of these numbers itself. And therefore we get 3870, which is product of these two numbers. Now come to the sixth problem, 15, 30 and 90. Again, all three are divisible. Are they divisible by any number? Actually, yes, it was divisible by 5. Here I have taken 2 just to show you that even though if I select two numbers which are completely dividing these numbers, then also it is fine. Either you go for all the three numbers or you can select any two numbers. Here I have taken all three into consideration. Here I have considered only 30 and 90. So at a time, if two are divisible, you can choose that number as well. ideally dividing all the three numbers at a time should be taken as I have taken in first fourth problem. Okay, coming back to here, even though if I do by this method, the answer is, we are getting the correct answer. Just see now, 15, 30 and 90. Here you may think that all three numbers are divisible by 5, so I should have chosen 5 first. That is also okay. If not, you see at least two numbers, 30 and 90 are divisible by 2. So I have written 2. 15 is not divisible by 2. So 15 I have written as it is. 30 divided by 2 is 15. 90 divided by 2 is 45. Now all these 3 are divisible by 3. So 3, 5, 5 and 15. Now all these are divisible by 5. So you have 1, 1 and 3. Alright. So what you get LCM as? Numbers in the first column multiplied by numbers in the last row. So you get 2 into 3 into 5 into 1 is 1 and 1 into 3 is 3. So I have written 3 over here. Again you get the answer 90. Now before I do this, let me tell you, if I am using what I have done in this case. Okay, dividing all the numbers, dividing or taking the number which is dividing all the three numbers at a time. Let us go by that method also. Okay, now all three are divisible by 3. Smallest is 3. Then we'll go for 5. Okay. So, let me erase this and then I'll show you. I just want to show you it doesn't make any difference. Alright. Now, I'm choosing 3. So, this is 5s are, here 10s are and here 30. Now, choose the number which is dividing all 3 at a time. It is 5. 2, 5 is not divisible by 2. 5 is not divisible by 3. So, I have to use 2. I have to use 5. So, I write 5 over here, 5 1s are, 5 2s are and 5 6. Now, at least 2 are divisible by 2. Okay, by 2 if I divide, then I get 2 1s are 2 and 2 3s are 6. So, at the end, what am I getting? 3 into 5 into 2, 3 into 5 into 2 multiply by 3. So, see, you get the same answer. Okay, fine. Let us go for seventh problem now. 105 and 195. These are divisible by 3. 3 being the smallest, I have chosen 3 first. You get 35 and 65. Again, these both are divisible by 5. 35 is not divisible by 3 as well as 2. So, I have to go for 5. 7 and 13 after dividing. Now, these both are prime numbers. So, I can't go ahead. So, what will be your answer? 3 into 5 into 7 into 13. The product gives you 1365. Okay, I hope the concept is clear. We'll stop.